drink alcohol in high school? Usually it's a dollar, $2, maybe 50 cents. 안녕하세요. 제 이름은 헤이린입니다. 도박의 미국인입니다. 반갑습니다.
언제 얼마나 될까요?
그 3년 돼서요. 3년. 아직도 아니야. 3년. Festivals, we usually have, well, we have prom, obviously. And then we have a lot of, in my school personally, we had a lot of fundraisers for football. Like, and then we also had pep rallies. Pep rallies are like, everyone goes, the whole school goes to the gym. And they're usually right before football games. So the cheerleaders and the dance team will dance and we'll have like screaming competitions, which year can scream the loudest, and we play games and stuff. And, yeah. Yeah, so prom is usually for the seniors only, seniors last year, fourth year. And it's usually, in my case, it was usually in the spring, so maybe April, around May, something like that. And you get a really fancy dress or a really fancy tux, and you go with your boyfriend or your girlfriend, and you go dance. And it's usually until like 10, 11 p.m., usually until late night. You go there and you dance, and you eat food, and then they will usually vote for a prom king and a queen, and then you go up there, you get a crown, and then you kiss, and then you dance, and then... And then a pep rally is usually kind of like these little mini parties, I guess. The whole school goes to the gym, and then each year is separated in a different section, and they're usually before football games. So it's to help cheer up the football games and give them support. So the cheerleaders will dance, and the dance teams will dance, and the mascots, and everyone is screaming and dancing, and then they will also usually do some games with like the principal or the teacher. So like you can just see your teachers embarrass themselves in front of the whole school. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I like pep rallies. I actually didn't go to prom, but I did go to the pep rallies. I drink alcohol? In high school? No, I really did. One time I tried it. I was at a party and they're like, hey, let me try it. It's really good. It tastes like peach. And so I drank it and I threw it up because it didn't taste like peach. It was vodka. It didn't taste like peach at all. I did not drink in high school. Yes, so there's two that come to mind. The first one is the kissing booth. And I think you see a lot of that in movies too, like kind of like teen drama movies. And then there's also something called the dunking booth. Yeah, there's usually a teacher inside of like a tank, and you throw a ball, and if you hit the target, then the teacher falls down into a tank of water. It's a lot of fun. usually it's for charities. So usually, sometimes there's only one person, but usually there's like a few people behind the booth, and you pay a certain amount to kiss a person that is behind the booth, and then the money goes to the charity that they are fundraising for.
How much usually?
It's usually not too expensive. I think sometimes they do have the option, but usually it's $1, $2, maybe 50 cents if you really want to get a kiss. I don't know. Usually maybe $1, $2.
What's the value of the 50 cents?
Like one piece of bubble gum or like a candy from the candy machine. Not much.
How far does it go?
Ew. I don't know. In the movies or in real life? In real life, I think not really anything more than like a kid, like a peck. But I don't think I've ever seen anyone go in like, yeah, I don't think I've ever seen that. Because usually you're kissing like a stranger, right? So unless you know them, I don't really think anyone wants to deep kiss for $1. No, not only king and queen can open it. Pretty much anyone can do it. But I mean, man, I'm gonna sound mean if I say this. But obviously, like, if you wanna raise a lot of money for your booth and you're doing a kissing booth, then you should probably be like attractive, good looking. Because no one, you know, no one wants to like, you know? I mean, maybe some people do. Wait, the usual guideline is that you should be attractive, good looking, so that you can make more money. because more people want to kiss you. Cute!
So is there like a special rule for this kind of special kissing booth?
I don't think there's any rules. Just like don't like be crazy. Like don't attack the person that you're kissing. Like don't be like disrespectful. Sometimes they do like animal kissing booths and it's really cute and I love it. Literally just don't bite the animal. I don't know. Just mwah and go. Just don't disrespect anyone. Don't be crazy. He's handsome. I bet he's famous and he's handsome, so I bet he made a lot of money. She's so nervous. Wait, how are they gonna kiss? Are they actually gonna kiss? He's behind a glass wall. There's probably like 1,000 people that want to kiss him. Oh, ew. He asked if she was gonna tongue him. Ew, there's fog on the glass. The fog. Oh, goodness gracious. Well, that seems like a safer kissing booth. That's cute. See, that's a cute, like, less gross version of the kissing booth. I don't know why I feel like Chris Pratt did something like that. I have no idea. I don't think so. I think yes, like usually, especially if it's in a high school kissing booth, a lot of the guy's friends will come up and like jokingly kiss them as a joke. Or if you're gay, that's okay too. I don't know. But yeah, usually it's really fun. Anyone can go up. It's really fun if you are a guy or if you're really old. A lot of old people go up to like purposely kiss young people and like gross them out. Yeah. Today we talked about American style festivals. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.